welcome to all our viewers out there to the Donald G Love Competition Hall, bringing to you RSEQ Women's Volleyball, Sherbrooke, Green and Gold versus McGill Martlets. Both teams looking to hit the ground running, and this game will be brought to you by Ryan Brandy and Kuzi Muria. Ryan, what a couple of pre-game talk up to.
Basically, Kuzi, there are six games remaining for the Martlets here, and they are 6 points out of that crucial third-place spot. And it's crucial for two reasons. First off, is the top three teams only make the playoffs, but also the RSEQ qualifies three teams to nationals this year. So basically, if you make playoffs, you also get to go to nationals. So it's a very critical game for the Martlets in that sense. Over the Christmas break, they had some games. They played number 8 Ottawa and number 10 Manitoba, and they were victorious over those teams. And they also played number 4 Trinity Western. They didn't come out with a victory, but that's a very tough team, and they fared okay. So in their Christmas break, they played some very tough teams. I think that's going to do some good for them here in the new year, and they need to carry that momentum into this game because, like I said, they're 6 points out. They basically need to win out almost to make those playoffs, get that critical third spot. So it's interesting to see today if the Martlets, like I said, can carry that into the new year and come out here on fire and try and show the fans here at G Don Love Competition Hall what the Martlets are all about here in 2013.
Thanks a lot, Ryan, for that. As you can hear, probably the crowd's getting behind their teams already. This is the second game of 2013 season. Like I mentioned earlier on, both teams looking to hit the ground running, and the fans are looking for a fully involved match today. The teams just lining up on the sides as we wait for the first serve of the game.
McGill comes in 7 wins, 7 losses here in conference play. In last spot, as I mentioned, Sherbrooke 11-3 there in second spot. But the RSEQ has been tight all year in most games. It's always been back and forth. Montreal and Laval are both in the top 10, but McGill and Sherbrooke both receiving top 10 votes from all the coaches throughout the country. So the coaches know that the RSEQ is a tough conference. So let's see what type of game we get here today.
So, McGill Martlets awarded the serve. We are about to get underway. So, Ryan, tell me exactly, what are you expecting from this game? How do you think both teams are going to be coming out of the block?
Well, for the Martlets, I see Genevieve Plante having to play a crucial role. She's kind of moved up the kill count so far this season. She's McGill's top kill. She racks up the most kills for McGill. So you'll see Marcella Mansur, who is second in the country in assists. She's probably going to be trying to look to go to Jen's way early on in this game, set the tone. And she's also going to be going to rookie number 1, Catherine Omat. She's also been doing great this season for a rookie. As for Sherbrooke, they're going to go to their stud, Hassani. Leads Sherbrooke in kills, number 8 in the country in kills. So let's see how Jen and Hassani can get off to a start here today.
Thanks for that, Ryan. So as it stands right now, 2-1 to McGill Martlets. With Martlets to serve, it's Genevieve Plante with the serve. You know, just the first 3 points, errors from both teams, but as they start calming down, we're going to be expecting, you know, a lot of action, adventure.
Number
and point 2. McGill.
That was Rasat Nasser hitting into the net there for Sherbrooke. They went to a backcourt attack there. Looks like she had a hole in the block, but didn't get it over the net there.
Served by Genevieve, received well. Oh,
little tip there.
Follows through.
This setter is a rookie for Sherbrooke, number 8, Cole Belize Samard. Or no, that's number 6. Sorry, rookie Kim Robitaille. That's something you don't often see in the CIS. A rookie setter coming in, stepping in.
Catherine Amiot just missing a spike there, going out of the court.
Sherbrooke ball. Good reception. Hit, great reception again. Great continuity from both teams. Set. Hits the net.
Great save from Marcelo there.
Oh, what a kill. What a kill by number 14 there, Jessica Lambert from Sherbrooke. Sherbrooke 3, McGill 3. Both teams just showing their intentions early on in the game. Not going to let it slip.
That's a ball that I'm sure Coach Bellavo is expecting her libero to get to. She got her hands on it. Just needs a little bit better position to get that ball up and in play so Marcella can get her hands on it.
Oh, just miscommunication.
Missed timing there. Tried the middle to Virginie Hebert. Didn't quite get it.
No, you can just see.
That's one of the hardest plays in the game, Kuzi. And it takes tremendous timing and effort. A lot of practice.
No, definitely there, Ryan.
Oh. Little sinking serve there.
McGill just caught napping there by Roxanne Asseni. A third point of the game so far. She's on a roll. McGill will need to stop her early. But ball out. McGill point. McGill point with Virginie Hebert serving. Received well.
Free ball. Let's see if McGill can use it.
Oh, big blocks. Big blocks from Kim Robital. Sherbrooke 6, McGill 4. Sherbrooke starting to creep away slowly here.
Mentioned Kim Robitaille being the rookie setter there for Sherbrooke. She's 5'10", so she can also get up at the net and be a factor there with her blocking. Oh. Something you always love to see from a setter.
Great hit back court, but just creeps outside the court. Point McGill. You know, Ryan, the past 3 minutes since the game started, both teams have been, they haven't managed to calm down their nerves as such. You know, from a commentating perspective, how do you think, you know, the coach right now will be feeling towards both coaches as such?
A lot of people would just assume, you know, it's a new year, maybe it's some rust from the Christmas break, but both these teams had games over the Christmas break, so it's not rust, it's just... Maybe it's McGill's first time back at home. They were here home at Christmas break, but maybe just getting back in this RSAQ conference type feel, a little bit of nerves maybe for the Martlets, but let's see if they can settle in here. I don't think it's anything to worry about. It's not like Sherbrooke is bringing their game either. So it's just taking what Sherbrooke gives you. When you get those free balls, use them and try and put them away.
Yeah, definitely. You brought up an interesting point there. And definitely it's true to say that, you know, the team that's going to win at this stage from what we are seeing right now is the team that makes less errors. Mm-hmm. And as you mentioned earlier on, both teams are just making far too many errors. And that will be something the coaches will be angry about.
Nice little dig there from MC. She's top 10 country in the dig, so she's one of McGill's best defenders.
Oh,
great block there from Northfleet and Jen Plant.
Big blocks indeed. McGill.
I'm also expecting a big game from Ashley Northfleet. She's a rookie. She's got some power up in the middle. Something McGill's kind of lacking. They haven't had much of a middle presence this year. They lost Kaiva Mateus from last year. She was an All-Canadian, one of their bright spots up in the middle. So that's something they've been looking for all year, and we already saw Marcelo go to Virginie Hebert early on in the game, but they couldn't connect. They didn't have the timing. So that's another key to this game, to see what McGill can get out of their middles.
Quick attacks. Yeah, definitely, Ryan. So Sherbrooke wins another point with miscommunication up front once again, and they're now leading 9-7 with Corinne Santerre with the serve. Oh, poor reception.
I think Catherine Amott thought that maybe going out, hesitant a little bit.
Hesitant indeed.
Wasn't quite sure.
This Sherbrooke starting to creep away from the game. 10-7. Oh,
great hit from Jen Plant. Some power there, but a great dig from Sherbrooke. Keeps it in play.
Great reception. No, this is a new interesting tactic we're seeing from the setter. She sees that the team's under pressure, so she gives it to the best spiker just to relieve a bit of pressure from the team. You know, just to get more points.
Oh. There it is. Jen just wanted that point. She thought she crushed one earlier on in that point, but it got dug and back in play. When she wanted it again, she told Marcella, give it to me. And that's what Marcella exactly did right there.
Big hit.
Beautiful set, beautiful hit. And I mentioned that was one of my first keys to the game. Watching out for Jen Plant, the leading kill getter for McGill.
And Sherbrooke not wanting to get matched by that last spike from Genevieve. Release one of their own with a big hit on the three. Sherbrooke 11, McGill 8. With Nasir with the serve. Great reception. Quick attack. Fished over.
Nice step back there from Virginie.
Now, what's been impressive so far is definitely both teams' vigilance at the net.
Mm-hmm. Marcel tries the signature Mansur dump there. Sherbrooke read it, but
unfortunately, hit out.
McGill still, I think that was a tip there, Kuzi, so McGill gets the point.
Get the point. Oh.
I think it was tipped at the net.
Tip. Okay. So, McGill point. 9-11. Serve. But poor reception. Forces the setter to fish it over. Blocked out as well. Oh. No, Sherbrooke point.
Marcella going right back to Jen there. She hits the wire though.
Putting the setter under a bit of